Students to session number 9. Today we are going to continue with the chapter 2, that is units and measurement. And today we are going to study various topics which are important from exam point of view and which may be asked in the exam. So let us focus the very first topic, that is accuracy and measure precision. First topic is accuracy and precision. Now what does this actually accuracy and precision means? Let us discuss in detail. Every measurement, you will able to see, every measurement is limited by, the reliability, of the measuring instrument. How perfect is your measuring instrument? Your quality of measurement will depend upon how perfect your instrument is. So that is the reliability of the measuring instrument. And skills of the person making measurements. Clear? Every measurement depends upon two things: the reliability of the measuring instruments, and second, the skill of the person who is taking measurements. Clear? Moving ahead, if we repeat measurements, means if we are taking more observation, able to see that we do not get the same result as obtained as the previous one. Yes or no? There is some variation. We do not get the same results as the previous one, but varies due to experimental error. There is some error hidden into it, that's why we are not able to get the same answers every time. The imperfection in measurement can be described in two ways. The very first we are going to talk about, that is accuracy. It refers to the closeness of a measurement to the true value of the physical quantity. I can give you example. If your true value is 2.32 seconds and your measured value is 2.31 seconds, this closeness, how your measured value is close to true value is given by what? Accuracy. Closeness is given by accuracy. Till this clear? How much your measured value is close to your true value, that is being shown by what? Accuracy. Till this clear? Hope it is clear. Moving ahead. If we are reducing errors, we will be more close to the actual value, yes or no? So you can say that it will be more accurate. Till this clear? Next important term, that is precision. It refers to limit to which It refers to limit to which quantity is measured. Quantity is measured. It refers to the limit to which quantity is measured. Is known as what? Precision. Is known as precision. Till this clear? Precision is determined by precision is determined by precision is determined by you can say LC of measurement. LC means least count. LC is nothing but what? Least count. LC stands for least count. Least count is nothing but what? You can say the smallest division on measuring scale is called your LC. More precisely, I can write as the smallest measurement is called least count of that instrument. Yes or no? I can say your general scale, everybody knows. LC of that general scale is what? 0.1 centimeter. Yes or no? 0.1 centimeter. Think, it starts from 0. 0, then first division 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, then 0.6, 7, 8, 9, and that is 1. So you can say 0.1 centimeter. Yes or no? Yes. You can say that is 0.1 centimeter. If you want to convert it into other unit also, you can. But LC of the normal scale is 0.1 centimeter. Here LC, how LC is related to precision, I can tell you. If LC is minimum, more precise, you can say. It's more precise. If LC is maximum, least precise. If LC is maximum, least precise. Clear? Less, minimum LC, more precision. Maximum LC, least precision. Till this clear? I will clear you with more example. Like, suppose you are having LC of first instrument. LC of first instrument is found to be 0.1. LC of second instrument is found to be 0.01. LC of third instrument is found to be 0.001. Out of three, which of the following is really minimum value? C. This is most precise. This is most precise. And this is the least. This is maximum in this case. And this is the least. So least will be most precise. And this would be what? Least precise. This will be least precise. Till this clear? Now I can give you with the example. Three students are asked to find the mass of a piece of metal whose mass is taken to be or you can say known to be 0.520 grams is the original mass of that metal piece. Clear? Here you will be able to note that we are taking one example in which three students are allowed to take a measurement of a mass piece of a metal, and the true value of the mass of the piece is found to be 0.520 grams. Till this clear? Now you can see that there are three digits after decimal place. So you can consider your LC to be what? 0.001. Yes or no? LC will be 0.001 grams. Now student A, student B, student C, they are individually taking three measurements. Measurement 1, measurement 2 and measurement 3. Measurement 1 is 0.52 grams, 0.51 grams, 0.50 grams and average is 0.51 grams. 0.516 gram, 0.515 gram, 0.514 gram, your answer is 0.515 gram, that is their average. 0.521, 0.520 and 0.520, the average is 0.520 gram. Now here you can note one thing over here. Here after decimal there are two digits. You can see. We can think over here that LC will be what? What would be the LC over here? Can anybody tell me what would be the LC over here? LC over here will be what? Can easily answer. I can say it's LC 0.01 grams. Here LC 0.001 grams. Here LC 0.01 grams. Yes, sir? Least LC. Out of three, which is having the least LC? These two. So these two are more precise. Yes or no? Yes or no? More precise or no? Yes. Now, out of the three conclusion, we'll able to see that for the student A, for the student A, you have to think. For student A, LC is not getting matched with the measured value. Yes or no? True value. Here it is 0.01 grams and here it is 0.001 grams. So, for this, you will able to note that for candidate A, measurement, it's neither precise nor accurate. Accurate means it is not close to the given value. It's 0.520 gram and it's 0.51. It is not close. Also, the LC is here is 0.01 and here LC is 0.001. LC is not also matching, so neither precise nor accurate. For the candidate B, you can say 0.01 gram, 0.01 gram, LC is same. So you can, it is precise. But value is 0.515 and here value is 0.520, which is not so close. So you can say it's more precise but not accurate. More precise but not accurate. But not accurate. Till this clear? For candidate C, we can see that LC 0.01 grams, 0.0 grams agree. You'll see it's 520, it's very near to true value. So you can say that for C, it's both precise as well as accurate. Hope the concept of precise and accurate is cleared over here. Now moving to very next important topic from the exam point of view that is going to be asked 100%. That is types of errors. We'll see in detail. Moving to the next topic, that is types of errors. The very first error is constant error. Now what the word constant itself indicates that the value will remain same in each observation. Then you can consider this type of errors to be what? Constant errors. The errors which affect each observation by same amount are called constant errors. See here I have already listed a few points for these errors because it is a very big topic. So I have already written the theory into the various easiest way in points to remember. So you can be comfortable enough to prepare this theory because it is very time consuming. So I have already written this. Now moving ahead, the errors which affect each observation by same amount. I have given one example. Observation 1 is 4.63 seconds. Observation 2 is 4.65 seconds. Observation 3 is 4.67 seconds. And observation 4 is 4.69 seconds. Here you will able to notice that between two consecutive numbers, between two consecutive observations, there is difference of 0.02 seconds. Next to 0.02 seconds. Next to 0.02 seconds. This indicates that in each and every observation, there is a difference of what? 0.02 seconds, which is constant throughout all the observations. Hence, errors of same amount, such type of error is known as constant error. Hope it is cleared. Due to cause for this error? Due to faulty calibration of the scale of measuring instrument. This is manufacturer default. Manufacturer defaults, you cannot say more precisely, but you can say that if the object is made well, the instrument is perfect, but calibration means what? To mark, to start its initial measurement from zero. Yes or no? Have you went to jewelers? When you see that they start, when they push the button of that weighing scale, it indicates 0.0000 grams. This zero stands for what? Calibration input. Means the starting indication should be zero. It should not be 0.1. Then your all measurement would be wrong. So your starting condition should be zero, and this is known as calibration of instrument. Calibration has to be done. And you'll able to notice that after using it for many times, sometimes you'll able to notice that the calibration is being disturbed. Though you will initiate the instrument again, you'll able to notice that it will show some reading rather to show zero. Again, you have to calibrate the instrument to mark its initial position to be what? Zero. Till this clear? So faulty calibration of this measuring instrument can cause such type of constant error. I can show you that suppose the weighing scale starts with 0.1. Then the very first actual reading might be 0.6, but it is showing 0.7 due to that 0.1 error. Next 0.8, 0.1 error, then 0.9. Remedies: measuring same physical quantity by a number of different methods or apparatus or technique. You can do what? You can measure the same physical quantity by different methods, or either you can use different apparatus to check the quantity of the error that is being measured. Next is systematic errors. The errors which tend to occur in one direction, either positive or negative, are called systematic errors. The errors which are either positive, tending into one direction, either all negative, then you can say such type of errors to be systematic errors. Systematic errors have various types into it. Subtypes, I can say. The very first is instrument error. Instrumental error. Now, the name itself suggests instrumental error. Error occurred by instruments. Errors occur due to inbuilt defect of measuring instrument. For example, you can say that is inbuilt defect. From the manufacturing plant only, the device is having some defect. Such type of errors is known as instrumental error. Wearing of the meter scale at one end. Suppose I can give you example that if you are having a scale like this, and if this end is being damaged, and you start measuring assuming here to be zero, your measurement is going to have error for sure. It's not going to be have perfect. Clear? So wearing of the meter scale at one end. Second, calibration of the scale. Calibration means what? The marking should be very perfect. The spacing between the marking should be very perfect. It should be not like that here it is very large, here it is very low, large, small. The gapping should be perfect. That is means calibration of the scales. Error can be detected by measuring physical quantity with two different instruments or two different methods. Here also you can, instrumental error can be reduced by what? You can measure same physical quantity by two different apparatus or two different methods. Till this clear? Next is imperfection in experimental technique. Imperfection in experimental technique means these errors are due to limitation of experimental arrangement. If you don't know how to perform the experiment, and then this will lead to what such type of errors? Experimental technique. Example, radiation loss in calorimetric experiments. Calorimetry means nothing but what? The process of measuring heat is known as calorimetry. And calorimetry is nothing but a device that is used to measure heat. Calorimetry is the process of measuring heat, and calorimeter is the device to measure the heat. So radiation loss means heat loss. If there is heat loss in the instrument, how can you measure the amount of heat to be perfect? Your reading would not be perfect because there is some loss. Heat is being lost to the environment. So there is radiation loss in calorimetric experiments. Second is buoyancy of air when we weigh the body in air. Of course, when you weigh the object dipped into the water, there will be buoyancy effect on it. Yes or no? Everybody knows what is buoyancy. We have already studied in chapter 9. The upthrust that is being acting upon the object by the surface of the liquid is known as what? Buoyancy. Yes or no? So this is buoyancy of air when we weigh the body in air. You will able to see the same effect in jeweler shop. If you went to jeweler shop, you will able to see over there, goldsmith, they are having their weighing scale in the glass box. Why? If they kept into the open, because the measurement is very minute. If they were kept into the open, the air effect would happen over there. That's why they are enclosing the measure weighing scale into what? Glass box. Till this clear? Next type of error is known as personal errors. The errors arises due to individual bias, lack of proper setting of apparatus, or individual carelessness in taking observation. Yes, if individual is not, you can say, more accurate, more attentive while taking measurements, then he may do some personal errors. That is solely depend upon the individual. Example, errors due to parallax. I have already explained what is parallax. I have already explained parallax is nothing but what? The apparent shift in the position of the image. Yes or no? That is one thing but parallax. Yes or no? The parallax, I can give you one example over here. Suppose you are measuring some liquid in the test tube or burette pipette. You have to keep that pipette in front of your eyes rather to tilt your head here and there. If you tilt your head here and there, you will not able to see the meniscus end properly, and you may take wrong reading. Clear? Due to parallax. The remedies for this is repeated measurement by different persons. Either you can change the person and get the readings. Second, by removing personal bias as far as possible. Either you have to improve yourselves. Clear? Next is error due to external cause. The name itself shows what is external cause. due to temperature, pressure change, wind change, etc. Such errors are caused by what? Change in external conditions like pressure, temperature, wind, etc. For example, I can give you that if the scale is being made up of, measuring scale is being made up of a metal, metal expands on heat, yes or no? If the temperature of the surrounding environment increases, you will able to see there is expansion in that meter scale, yes or no? And that expansion can lead to what? Error. Such type of error is known as errors due to external causes. I can give you one example. Have you seen railway tracks? There is a gap between two tracks, track lengths, yes or no? The gap is being put over there in order that in summer the rails are direct exposed to the atmosphere. Due to higher temperature, the track might increase its length and fill that gap between this. If they might not put that gap, what will happen? The track will bend over each other and will lead to an accident. Clear or not? Remedies: controlling external condition during experimental. You have to control the experimental external condition while you are performing experiments. Random errors: the errors which occur irregularly at random in magnitude and direction. Sir, what do you mean by magnitude over here? Magnitude means either it is large or small. Direction means either positive or negative, are called random errors. Causes: slight variation in attentiveness of observation during experimentation. Yes, if observer is careless, not attentive while taking readings during experimentation, he might create random error. See, random error can be introduced knowingly, unknowingly. It may be to a very large extent or it may be to a very low extent. It may be either positive, it may be either negative. That's why the name is random error. Remedies: random error have almost equal chances of positive or negative errors. Hence, arithmetic mean of large number of observations can be taken true value of the measured quantity. See here, arithmetic mean is highlighted word over here. Why we are taking arithmetic mean over here? The reason to take arithmetic mean over here is nothing but simple. In order to reduce such random errors, and to get the exact true value of the physical quantity. Next is the least count error. I have already discussed. It is uncertainty associated with the resolution of measuring instrument. LC is nothing but smallest division on the scale of measuring instrument is called as least count. For scale, you are having 1 mm, suppose LC, then error can be half of its LC means 0.5 mm plus or minus. Or if I convert this mm into centimeter, it will be 0.05 centimeter. Till this clear? The last error is gross error. The last error is gross errors or mistakes. These errors are due to either carelessness of a person or due to improper adjustment of the apparatus. Yes, if your apparatus is not properly adjusted, this error might occur. Or due to either carelessness of a person, if a person is not attentive or if it is careless enough while taking observation, this error may lead to happen. No correction can be applied for gross errors. Gross error has no corrections. Clear? Individual biasness has to be improved in order to minimize these gross errors or mistakes. Hope till this clear all the errors. Now moving on to the very next topic, that is absolute error, relative error and percentage error. The next topic we have elimination of errors. Elimination of errors. Normal or Gaussian law of random errors. Normal or Gaussian laws of random errors. Of random errors. Shows that the probability of occurrence of positive and negative errors is same. So random error can be minimized by repeating measurements. You have to repeat the measurements in order to reduce what? Random errors. Till this clear? Now there are two cases I can give you over here. There are two cases normally we used to get in the numericals. So the first case is true value given, or in the second case you are having true value not given. if true value is not given, then what you have to do? You have to take arithmetic mean of all the observations and you have to consider that value to be what? True value of the physical quantity. If true value not given, then you have to take arithmetic mean of all measurements can be all measurements can be taken as the true value of the measured quantity true value of the measured quantity till this clear? If not given, then you have to take arithmetic mean to be what? True value of that quantity. Now we are going to study the topic, that is absolute error, relative error and percentage error. We are going to study three errors today, that is absolute error, relative error and percentage error into this topic. Now moving ahead, if you are having observation, if you are performing experiments and you are having observations, if a1 comma a2 comma a3 up to an be the n measured values of a physical quantity. If these are the recorded observations of physical quantity, then if true value is not given, then true for the case of true value, what you will do? A bar, or you can say a mean, that is equal to what? Arithmetic mean you are going to take as what? A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4 up to what? An. How many terms? N. So divide by n, they're going to give you mean, and this mean is considered to be what? True value of physical quantity. True value of physical quantity. Till this clear? Okay, moving ahead. Error, everybody knows what is definition of error. Error, that is equal to what? True value minus measured value. True value minus measured value. Yes or no? This is your basic step, that is error is equal to true value minus measured value. Moving ahead to the very first, that is absolute error. Very first, that is absolute error. Now how to calculate absolute error? What is absolute error means? The magnitude of difference between true value of quantity and the individual measured value. Individual measured value is called absolute error. It is denoted by delta A. Clear? So delta A1, you can say that is your A bar true value minus measured quantity, that is A1. Yes or no? And here you have to remember that you have to take as bar mode of this. You have to take mode of this. Till this clear? For second reading, delta A2, it is equal to mode of A bar minus A2. Delta A3, that is equal to mode of A bar minus A3. Delta AN, this will continue, delta AN, that is equal to a bar minus a n. Till this clear?